The driving program for Viking, as it is for the current Mars program, is Mars Alive? Is there life on Mars? On Mars, we're really fortunate, but in contrast to Earth, where all the old stuff gets buried down with plate tectonics, it's very hard to find ancient material. On Mars, a very good fraction of the surface is very, very old. So we can go back to different points in Mars history just by going to different places on the surface of Mars. So that history is still being explored. And the tools, of course, we have to explore it now are the Curiosity rover. Almost every day, at least every week, we go and look at the images that are coming down from Mars, go over a hill, see a new site. It's just a new world exposed to us. We landed in August of 2012. In February of 2013, we finally drilled our first hole. We all concluded that in terms of habitability, we had hit pay dirt. Liquid water had formed these materials in a relatively neutral environment. Clays had formed, and potentially there were organics from carbon dioxide released from the sample. Viking had concluded they really hadn't seen organics, or their early conclusions were what they saw might have been from a little bit of terrestrial contamination left over, even though the instrument was working great. The very simplest organic molecule, methane, had been observed remotely from Earth-based observations. We went to Mars and we saw these methane spikes, generated all sorts of excitement in the press, lots of interest in methane. And so the question is it biological or is it coming from water-rock interactions? If you have water-rock interactions, potentially methane from very ancient times may be stored in clathrates, and then when you get an impact or something, the methane may be released into the atmosphere. And so the picture that's emerging is present Mars looks like what you see on the right. Ancient Mars with the lakes and so on might look like what's on the left. But again, the problem of how long that was maintained is really an outstanding problem in Mars science. So that is the view from Mars Science Lab Curiosity. We're going to continue to use our tools as long as we're roving along to look at the history recorded in these layers. And so stay tuned. We'll hopefully have lots more discoveries from Mars Science Lab Curiosity.